What's up, everybody? This is Zeferitas. We're gonna try one more time, and then it'll probably just be a YouTube video if it doesn't work. But I've switched some things. Hopefully it'll stay on. I'm not too hopeful after the last two tries. But yeah, let's see. So last time, so we're starting on the arms. Once again, I'm going to show you guys what happened last time. You can see all the missiles and the Gatlings and the, you know, all the Vulcans on the shoulders. Got all that done, the head. And now we're going to start the arms. We seem to be all right now. It's kind of weird, though. I don't know why it was not liking Wi-Fi. But that's odd. Sorry about that, chat. I was just putting Do Not Disturb on so we don't get dings and all that. But we are ready now. And it does seem to be better, and it's not crapping out on us again. Alright. So, like I said before, if you were here, we're going to go ahead and start doing the arms. Yep, it does seem to keep working. That's good. All right. So we have to do one arm at a time, and we're actually finishing the right arm right now. So let's see, we need XA15, which is, that's XB, XA15. Aha, there he is. Welcome in, welcome in. How are you guys doing tonight, chat? On this glorious Saturday. I'm just cleaning it up a little bit. You gotta be very careful, though, as to not cut the piece. Yeah, you could use a little bit more. Just remember, chat, when you're using a knife, be very careful about how you use it. Alright, so we got that one. And now we need XA13 from the same rack. Right here. Here we go. Alright, so now we got those two, but we need a PC-10, and that's very important. We have to have that. If we don't have that, we won't be able to put the hands in. So PC-10. Aha, up here. Separated from everything else, but that's fine. There we go. The piece looks pretty good, actually. I'm not going to worry about anything on it. All right, so what we got to do. At least what it looks like, anyway. I'm gonna slot it right in here. Right into this little notch here. There we go. Just like that. And then we gotta put this on. One way or another. There we go, on that way. There we go, now we have an arm joint. There we go. Okay, and next we need D10, which would be this guy right here. And this guy right here. What about you guys, chat? Do you guys have favorite Gundam or mobile suit from any of the series? Or anything like that? Personally, my favorite is probably the Death Scythe. I really like that one. However, I wouldn't want to use it because I am not a stealth guy. I am not a good stealth guy. If you go and watch some of my games that I play, you know I'm very bad at it. Oh, sure, I've played and beaten, you know, some of the Metal Gear Solids and all that, but I'm just generally not good at it. I don't have the patience for it. And some people really, really like that kind of thing. But I'm just not that good at it. Alright, we need C12 now, chat. C12. C12. Ah, that's right. C is red. There we go, one of these. Actually, they're both 12, which is interesting. Actually, you know what? We'll just go this way. Clean it up a little bit because it definitely needs it. But another mobile suit I really like is also the Serpent, one from the Endless Waltz. I do really like that design. It was actually quite cool. And also the Tall Geese. I do really like the Tall Geese. I like the concept behind it that they had as well. Like, it was a mobile suit not for fighting, but for basically dueling, to give up your life. I thought that was always interesting. And when Zex Marquise used it the first time, I thought that was really interesting. How it was like that. And that it almost killed him when he used it. I always thought that was interesting. Yeah, and his friend Otto, yeah, he died from that. It's a little hard to see. I'm thinking it doesn't really matter. Unless it does matter. There we go. So we got that part on. I know you can't see it, chat, but there's like, I don't know if it'll focus. But there's two little lines here. You gotta line it up on the inside. And it's not really wanting to do it.
Come on, get in there. There we go. Alright, we got it. There we go. Alright. Got it, chat. One arm segment right here. Take me a quick little drink here, chat. And now we need F3. That's going to be a tiny little guy. CF. Do do do. All right. And 3. Yeah, 3. Okay, and there's several of them. So we're kind of probably going to have to put 2 each on each arm. That's what's going to happen here. But he's just a tiny little guy. Lots of very small pieces in this one here, chat. Ooh, and it didn't come off very well. So we're going to have to kind of try and clean it up a little bit. If we can. There we go. And let's see, it goes right in the joint here. Somewhere. Oh, you know what? I think we have to take this off here real quick. Because what it's showing Oh, no, never mind. That's a different piece. That's a different piece entirely. Never mind, chat. I was thinking it was this piece right here, but it's not. It's another piece that we gotta stick on. Alright, so we need B2. B2, wherever you are. E. B. This guy right here. And then 2. Yeah, this guy. Both of these guys. Give it a little clean up here. All right. Oh, that's right. And we got to put both of these on. So let's see. Goes a specific way. And it looks kind of difficult. Uh-oh. There we go, chat. We got it on there. Focus, please. Please. Well, I guess that's as best as it's going to let you show it, but it is quite small. So we got to do that again on the same piece. Just trying to get it off here, chat. There we go. Touching it up here. Maybe too small right now. So I think we're just going to go ahead and put it on. There we go. We got both on now. And that goes over the top. Excuse me, chat. Had a little sneeze. All right. I think that's it. I think that's what we got right there. Those just give it a little detail for the little arm joints. I do wish it would focus a little better, but it's all right. All right, on to step 3-7. So on 3-7, we need XA3. So that's this guy right here. And three, which is this guy right here. Give it a little sprucing. All right, that's good enough, I think. All right. And then we need XB16, which is going to be a finger. Actually, I think it's the thumb. Yeah, so we're building the hand right now, chat. All right, there we go. Actually, we'll put that over here. Yeah, it looks pretty clean. I tried to make every cut pretty clean. So, let's see here. This way. Like so. And now we need A21 to cover that part up.
A is this one, yeah, the multicolor.
So it specifically wants this one. How about you, chat? Have you guys built any models or anything? All right. And let's see. Yep. It goes on just like I thought. Alright, and there we go. That's what we got so far, chat. So we just got a thumb here. And we're getting ready to put the fingers on. Which apparently is just one piece. XA7. So actually it looks like there's multiple hands for different things. XA7. So this one's going to be the gripped hand. I don't know if he'll be able to see very well, chat, but... it's just a gripped hand like that. Well, minus the thumb. So, like that. Alright, now we have a hand. And now we need F15. Aha, there he is. There it is right here. This guy. Give him a little clean up here. I think that's good. All right. And so the fat side goes on here. Maybe. There we go. I guess it just kind of sits in there. Doesn't actually lock in. Which is interesting, but okay. It's just kind of loose in there. But now we have an arm. There we go. It's not quite... Oh, no, it is done. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and put them on. Then, because I thought it wasn't quite done, but it is. There we go. There we go, chap. Now he's got an arm. Alright, so, we got the left arm now. Let's get that started. So this will be part of what you guys missed last time when stream went down. Well, let's see, what do we need? We need first, we need F11 and E3. So we need F11 that'll be this guy right here and we also need E3 to also be this guy. So this one is very, gotta be very careful with this one. Getting this one out right here. They are very thin. So you have to cut them, but you gotta cut them very carefully. Kinda gotta hold it a bit. I almost bent one last time, chat. It was not good. But we didn't. I want you to see, chat, but I gotta be very careful with it, so I'm just gonna kinda... do it the way I gotta do it here. There we go, we got it. Gonna have to clean it up some, but We got it. And I'll see if it'll pick it up for you guys. Yeah, and it's very thin, so that's why I have to be so careful with them. But the cleanup on these pieces is actually pretty easy. Because they are very flat as well. Go. So we have that. And now we need the F11. Which is this boy, big boy right here. So he's going to be part of the shoulder. And these weren't too bad to put together last time. I do have to admit, though, chat, I'm starting to see with these new ones, these updated Gundam Wing models, they're a lot better made than they were before. I mean, a lot. And I think they are a lot more fun to build now. I've built some of the pretty old ones, and man, they were hard. Because they were hard to read, the instructions and stuff. But all the pieces are molded much nicer and more detailed now than they used to ever be. Alright, so now we gotta put this in here. And it just snaps right in there. But you gotta push it in and make sure all of it's in. Because that's where we're gonna put the little missile caps right up in those little holes. Now they're not all individual, but it is pretty cool. Because they do have different rows and stuff. Alright, so we need F12, which is this 3 triangular shaped missiles. Missile heads, I should say. They're not actual missiles. They don't come out or anything, is what I mean. But they are pretty cool. Clean it up here and then I'll show you. And those are all together as one piece. And so we'll just slide it all up in here. And it actually looks very nice once it's in. It'd be a little hard to show you, but that's them right there. And so we got two more rows of those. We got a 3 and a 2 row. So that'll be F1. And this one is also 3 missiles, but this one is just 1 column. You'll see. So, see if I can get it a little bit closer. Yeah, just 3 little missile pods right there. And then we got the 2. So, we got to go back here, which is F2. This guy here. That one came off pretty clean, so it's good. And then just a little 2 guy. And he goes right in the bottom. Show you guys in just a second. So we got that right there. That's what it ended up looking like. So a lot of little details, but it's working. And let's see. So after that, we're on 4-2. Okay, we're starting on the rest of the shoulder. So we need F9. Oh, that was that same one again. Let's see. F9. This one right here. It's a big guy. You always want to be careful with the nubs that are attached to the sheet. You don't want to break those off because they're really, really, really hard to repair if you do. On a more recent one that I did, that I don't have with me right now, I ended up having to do that, buy some glue, and have to try and re-glue the nub back on, smooth it out, and try and get it to work back together again. It was not fun, chat. It was such a small little tiny piece, too. Ugh. By the way, chat, you can ask me anything. Anything basic or not, and if I can answer it, I'll answer it. I mean, don't ask me, like, what's the root of pi or something. I won't be able to tell you that. I'm not a math guy. Not at all. Alright, so we got F9. Now we need... We need this guy right here, which we built last time. He's just a little joint for the arm. And then we need, that's it. So all we need other than that is F35 and F34, and that just makes the, this right here, chat. This little, shoulder spike here. So we need F35. How is that possible? I don't even see 35 on here. You see it go to 30. But no 35. Yeah, that's strange. They have a second F, maybe? Oh, we do. Oh, I was looking at E. Dumb here. I was wondering why it was going to 30. These guys right here. 34 and 35. There we go. There. A little bit of cleanup here. Alright, here we go. So we got that. That one looks pretty good. Can't worry about it. Just gotta fit it together. There we go, now we got it. Got the little shoulder horn.
I don't know what else to call it.
All right, time to assemble all of it. Alright, so we got this right here. That goes there. They're like so. And then bam, together like that. And there we go. That's what we got right now, chat. All right, so next step is more details. Okay, we're gonna put the back cover on first this time. So we need A4 and E11. So let's grab A4 first. The numbers can be a little tricky to see in some of the parts on this one, chat. Like the yellow is very hard to see unless you get it close up and put it in the light. Kind of hard to see some of the numbers, what they are. But I don't mind because I would rather have the multicolored pieces like they are. They're very nice, very detailed. And I would rather have all of the models like this, to be honest with you. I would rather have no stickers at all. So, like, you know, some of the green, neon green parts. I would like them to have some of those for, like, the eyes and stuff. Which they do for certain ones, but not all. And I get it, it's expensive. Just to add a tiny little detail like that, I get it. But, I mean, just people like us who build them, you know, we would really appreciate that instead of having stickers. Because stickers can be kind of a pain, especially when they're very small. And this one came with a ton of stickers. I don't know if you'll be able to see them, but. And I'm not putting all these on. No way. I mean, that's just one sheet. And then a whole bunch of other ones like this. And I'm like, no thanks. I would rather them be on it already. And I get it. It's tricky. It's expensive to do it that way, but. I'm not putting all these stickers on. No way. Alright. Anyways, back to what we were doing, building. Here, I'm gonna actually adjust up a little bit. Alright, so we have that piece. We need E11. Which was the one we mistook for F. This guy right here. Another one of these flimsy guys. So we gotta be very careful. Got him. Well, it's doesn't have anything. It's just a piece. Oh, and if you guys haven't checked out the rest of my channels, I'll link it right here in the description here. I got some really cool stuff. I've got lots of videos up, both on YouTube and on Twitch. The ones on Twitch are not, they're just raw videos. They don't have, any edits or anything like that in them, on most of them. So I would very much appreciate if you guys would go there, like, subscribe, do all that good stuff for me. And don't worry, we're gonna be doing these about every weekend if I can. Because I do love building models. And I don't see that stopping anytime soon. And let's see. So we got those. We need F4. And that'll be the last piece we need in order to complete and assemble this. So this guy right here. Alright, so we got everything, so let's assemble this guy here. So we gotta put this guy right here into this guy first. Actually, it might be easier. I think it was easier if we did it this way last time. It just made it a lot easier. It does the same thing, but... just makes it easier to line up. we go. And there we go. We got a missile pod. The back missile pod.
All right.
And then it wants us to attach it. There we go. And there we go. So now we got missiles on both sides. And then it wants F-32. So we'll grab that as well. And it's about time for a stretch break here, chat. So I think what we'll do here is we will finish this one and then take a quick stretch break, and then we'll come right back at it. Which will only be, you know, about 5 minutes or so. So we needed, what again, F-33. Well, that's not good. Or are we looking at the wrong one? Might be looking at the wrong one. 32. Yeah, actually 32. Yep, we were looking at the wrong one, chat. We were looking at the right arm one, not the left. You're not missing anything right now, chat. All I'm doing is trying to get this piece off the sheet. There we go. Got it. All right, give it a quick little clean here. That's good enough. Yeah, that little spot, but there we go. Alright, and now I remember this being not where I thought it was. So it goes this way here. I thought it went on those nubs last time, and I tried to keep putting it on there, and it didn't work, and I kept wondering why. And then I realized, oh, there's just one little nub right here. That it fits right in one little tiny slot. But yeah. Alright, so we got that. Oh, we might as well just go ahead and do this one last thing here. And then the whole shoulder piece will be done. So we're just building the next yellow piece that sits right up in here. Now this one is really cool. I do like this little detail that it has here. They really kind of pop. So let's see, we need F6 and XA24. So XA24.
Now there's two XAs, so we got to figure out this. Okay, so we already took, no, we didn't take this one yet. But since there's two of these sheets, you got to make sure that I'm using the right sheet. There we go.
Give it a little clean up here. And this one's a little tough to clean because it is a very small piece. All right, that looks good to me. We have that, and we need F6. So let's see, F6. This guy right here. Yeah, give it a tiny bit of a cleanup, but it doesn't really need it all that much. There we go. All right. So this goes on first. This is actually kind of tough. I was having trouble with it last time. Alright, so now we got the hook on. That was the small little hook that we had to put on right there. And now, let's see. We need E4, which is right over here. And it's going to be this skinny guy right here. So, we got to be careful. Very careful. Like, I almost want to just break the arms off of the sheet instead. But I think it's just too flimsy even for that. There we go. Give it a little clean up. There we go. Honestly, I'm pretty satisfied with how that broke off. Really not much of anything on it. There we go. And then we need to put this on. It just snaps in there. That way we have the missiles in there now. All right, next step is, well, just to put it together, the A1, which is the last of the shoulder things
right here. Oops, okay. So it goes in like this. Ba-dunk. There we go. And that's how that is. And then we'll just hook that right back onto the full shoulder here. And wa-bam! Now we have the whole shoulder. There we go. Oh, we do have one piece left, actually. C2. It's just a white piece. It's a deep seat.
Nope.
Am I wrong? C2. Oh, that's right. I keep thinking that it's a different color, but no, it's actually red. I keep forgetting C is red. So C2, it said, I believe. Yeah, up here. There we go. Give it a little cleanup. There we go. And there we go. That's that final step right there. All right, so now we're going to take a quick 5-minute break here, chat. Make sure you drink water, eat food, stretch, all that good stuff. Do whatever you gotta do. I'm gonna do the same, and I'll be back in 5 minutes. All right, chat, we're back. Yeah, chat, if you go check out my YouTube channel and my Twitch channel, I play games every day, Monday through Thursday, and I'll have to put an update on my schedule that shows up, and we play Dot Hack, we play Apex, we play Diablo 2 and Diablo 4 currently, and oh, okay. I thought we were not live for a second. But we are. We still are. Okay. And go check out those videos. They're good. Especially the Dot Hack videos are quite fun. Come jump in with me when I play. It's usually pretty late at night because that's what my schedule is. But it's usually 11 o'clock at night, Monday through Thursday. And, you know, we just chat, talk around, and play video games and chill. So come meet me down there, and we'll have a great time. And all right, let's get back to it. So where we're at now is, that's right, we're putting a couple of details on the shoulder here. So we need F30. So F30. That's this guy right here. Give him a little clean up here. All right, we got that one. And then we need A20 as well. That's this sheet right here. And it is this guy right here. Give him a little clean up here. There we go. And we're gonna stick this guy right back here. Like so. And then we need oops. I think that's not right.
Something's not quite right. I think we need to get rid of this little nub thing here. I thought that was part of the piece, but I think it's not.
Because it doesn't go flush like it should. So we'll just clean that part up.
All right, that should work. There we go. Nice and flush. Okay, so that's what we did right there, chat. We stuck this one on, and then we put this little white piece on, too. All right, next step is 4-4, and we're going to need... Basically building the other arm like we did earlier, chat, when we first started. So we need this guy right here. We need XA14. It's an XB. XA14. Which is this guy right here. Give them a little clean up here. Alright, and we also need, from the same sheet, 16, which was just the one right below it, right here. Try and maneuver this guy out. There we go. Sorry about this, chat. I'm just trying to make sure you guys can still see me, but on my end, everything looks good. But when I'm in the app, from your guys' perspective, it's not loading. Oh, I see why. Okay. Well, we're still live, I think, so forget it. Just keep on going. want to finish this arm, and then we're going to call it a stream anyways, so. But after last time, it was kind of annoying how half of it didn't work, so. I just want to make sure that doesn't happen again. All right. Yeah, it looks like we're still good. All right. I'm using three devices here, Chad. I'm using this camera that you guys can see here. I got my laptop over here. And then I also have another phone down here to monitor the actual stream itself from your guys' end. Alright, so we got those, and we got them all cleaned up. And we need PC-10. So that's this guy right here. And it's right here. That came off nice and clean, so we're good. And now we gotta assemble. Alright. One of these. Actually, let's do it like we did last time. It made it a lot easier. So we put that in first. Put that on that side. And we put them all together. Something's not right here. That should be fine. It's not really going on right, chat. I don't know what's going on here, but I need to figure this out. All right, let's try this again. It doesn't seem to want to fit in correctly. You gotta figure out why that is. So there's gotta be something in the way, maybe. Something that needs clean up or something. It's just not fitting quite the way it should be. Alright, let's try this again. Try to reassemble it all the way again. Oh, come on. Troubleshoot some of these pieces here. Yeah, they just don't seem to want to fit correctly. My hands are getting very sweaty here, chat, which is making it extra difficult. Now, I know this piece goes in here like this. And it fits perfectly like that. Right there. That piece just doesn't really want to stick to that, and I don't get why. Doesn't really make any sense to me, but it likes the other side, just not the other one. Alright, well, it's together. It's not perfect, but it's as on as it's gonna get. So there we go. Unless, hold on, wait a second here, chat. We had it together, but I just want to double check something.
See if this'll fix that little problem we were having. I mean, it shouldn't, but... Nope, if anything, that made it worse. So, I guess... flip this around. It's the only two directions it can go, so it's kind of strange. We've done both of them multiple times. I mean, one of them has to be right. I mean, come on. They can't both be wrong constantly. Although, it might be like that USB phenomenon everybody always has. You put it in one way, flip it another way, and it does the same thing, and you're like, what the hell? You know what I mean? How's it going? Welcome in, welcome in. So we are building the Gundam Heavy Arms right now, and we are on the left arm. We're going to finish that up right here. For those of you who just joined in. So we got that, so we're good. So we need D11. Is this guy right here. So D11, which is this guy right here. So we're going to pop him out. Give him a little quick shave here. Although, actually, it looks pretty good, so I think we're good. Alright. And then we need C12, which is the red one. And it's this guy right here. If you guys got any questions, you know, just let me know in the chat. Be more than happy to answer. And we're gonna be doing this, at least for a few more model kits every weekend, as much as possible. And it will be right here at about 12:30, depending on how things go in my day. And we'll come and build model kits. I think the next one we'll do is we'll finish up one of the old... Tall Geese models that I have. It's a very old one. But it's actually very cool because you can turn it into whichever Tall Geese you want. It's like a 3-in-1 sort of. So you can build whichever one out of the same kit. It's actually pretty awesome. And I think I've decided I'm going to build Tall Geese 3. Personally, that one's my favorite out of the Tall Geese, but they're all pretty awesome. Alright, okay, so just assemble.
So we need this. Boom. Like so. Should be like this. Well, it doesn't seem to want to go in at all. Yeah, it's definitely this way. Oh, there it goes. All right, there we go. We got it. And this way. The way it's supposed to be going. Unless we messed up somehow. All right, so we got that. There we go, we got it on. There we go, that's what we were trying to do. I'm pretty sure it's supposed to go all the way down. Yeah, it is.
I can't seem to get it to go any further, though. And I'm not sure why. But we're also extra sweaty still. Alright, so let's try this again. It was not this hard last time, chat. Not even close. It just kind of fell right in last time. This time, it really doesn't want to go in, like, at all. And I'm not sure why. I feel like it has to do with this construction of this piece here, because it doesn't fit seamlessly, which it should, but it doesn't. And I'm not sure why. I've unbuilt it and rebuilt it again multiple times. It should just work, but it's not. I don't get it. It makes no sense, chat. It really makes absolutely no sense. It's the only way that it fits together, so I don't get it. This has to go in on this side. It has to. We have no choice. Because it's the only way that it actually stays on. And every single time we tried to make it better, it just doesn't. When we take it all apart, I don't see anything obstructing anything. That's the weirdest part. There's no obstructing things on the inside or dust or nothing. So I don't see what the problem is. Now, we do have, there. I don't know if you guys will be able to see it. There's that little nub there. And it says, putting the nub forward is what we want. Into this piece, which is what we did. It's what I'm currently doing. That's why I don't get why it's not fitting correctly. It seems like it's snug in there. And then I go to put this on. And it's just not flush. There's gaps. And no matter how hard I push on it, it doesn't change anything. So it can't be that. Come on. Okay, we got that piece back on. So let's try this part again. It's exactly the way it needs to be. And I can see those little spots where it's supposed to mesh with these little, I don't know if you guys will be able to see it, but yeah, these little lines right here, they're supposed to fit on the inside. There's some lines on the inside to fit into. And I see it, it's just not fitting. Alright. There we go. I think I got it. Finally, chat. Except now, we have another snag. Doesn't want to go any further on. And it's supposed to. Just comparing here, chat. Just don't get it, chat. It makes no sense. I don't know what is stopping the pieces from going together like they should. Yeah, I can't even get this back on at all.
No matter how I put it on. But that's how the other one is, and the other one went on just fine, super easy. Not even an inconvenience at all. I remember that. But this one's nothing but trouble. Yeah, this one was not even hard to put together at all. But this one doesn't want to go together at all. Okay, there we go. Got that for him. All right, let's try this again. There we go. Now it's fitting better. I didn't change anything either, Chad. It's kind of weird. Still not fitting completely, though. There we go. Got it. Alright. That was really actually very tough. I don't know why. But the other one was nowhere near that tough. I don't get it. But whatever. It's done now. I think it had to do with that gapping. We didn't have that gapping on the other arm. Alright, so now we need B2, which is this guy here, and it's this one again, one that we did earlier. Alright, and now we're just gonna clean it up just a tiny bit. Alright, now we gotta put those tiny little pieces on. Which should be 3. F3. Yep. 2 F3s. We gotta get those.
cleaned up and then put on. Now, these ones are actually important to clean because they're so small and they're just little nubs. So, gotta get those clean. And that looks good. Alright, so now we gotta put these little nubs on again. Just gotta figure out the... the orientation. How to put it on. There we go. Sure it's on there nice and good. Go, and then we got the other one. What I usually do, chat, is if it only has two prongs on it, I just kind of twist it out from the sheet. I think it's a lot easier and it comes off a lot cleaner that way. Like this one, I didn't have to clean at all. Alright, so we got those on. And now we need it to go... this way, I believe. Yep. And a little snap. There we go. And now we're on to 4-5. So for this one, we need did we not make that earlier? We need 3-2, which is on a different page, of course. Let's go back and take a look here real quick. Yeah, because that was a times 2. So let's take a look here. Did we not do that? So XB12. So if we don't have an XB12 on here, which we don't, on either, so we definitely made it. Did we go ahead and make the whole thing, maybe? Because I don't see the piece at all, chat. What happened to it?
didn't get assembled into anything, that's for sure. XB7 and 8. Yeah, they did get assembled. Well, shoot, chat. Can't seem to find the piece, though. That is not good. That is not good at all. Because it should have been in the box. Kind of strange. We had all the pieces at the beginning. Well, shoot. This is not good, chat. It's not good at all. Unless we accidentally used it somehow. But I can't see how that could be possible. So here's one. They want another one. And then we made one for this one. Wait, so there's supposed to be three of them? How is that possible? It's only a times two. That makes no sense, chat. That makes no sense. But I am counting three of those pieces that they want us to have. And this is a times two right here. Clearly see it says times two. Times two right here. And so we built that. And those went into both the arms. So, because there's one here, that's one. And then we used one here as well. And the same one, 3-2, 3-2. And now it wants us to use another one, which is 3-2. That's three. but there's only two sheets. Which is strange. Unless there was supposed to be three for some reason. Well, this is a predicament. Let me just double check what those pieces are again. Let's see. Yeah, they're all XBs. 12, 7, and 8. Yeah, all of them are gone. Well, what the heck? Well, what the heck, chat? How are we supposed to have three of something we only have pieces for two of? Huh? Hmm. It literally refers to 3-2. This is this is very not good. This is part of the arm assembly. So we need H15, which is here. And it's this. And 9. So it's these two right here. But they go together with that piece. That is so weird. I wonder if that's like a like a known mistake or something. I don't know. I mean, we don't have any more pieces for that. That is so strange. Alright, chat. Well, I guess I'll try and figure this out for next time, but I guess we'll just call it here, since we can't really finish what we got, because I'd need that piece, according to this. So I'll see you guys again on Monday at 11 p.m. EST. And we'll probably be playing some Diablo 4. That's probably what's going to end up happening. So I'll see you guys Monday for Diablo 4 or something close to that, you know. I mean, we'll figure something out. All right, actually, you know what, guys? I have a live poll that's up. You guys vote on something right there. It's right here in the description, actually. Or right here in chat, I mean. I'll post it again. Go to that poll and vote on whatever games you like that I play. And the one that has the most, I mean, maybe we'll just play that on Monday. So I'll see you guys then. Be good. Let's see. We might raid somebody here. Let's see. Let's see who's on right now. Let's go ahead and raid Akami. They are doing Pokemon Scarlet and Violet. So we'll go ahead and raid them, and I'll see you guys on Monday. Alright, chat. Be nice. Have a great day. This kind of sucks, but we'll figure it out. Bye.